Poruszymy do następnego referatu. Znów się przełączy na język angielski. We will have a contribution of Dr. Krisztina Kürti from Eötvös Loránd University of Budapest. Dr. Kürti researches mainly the questions of the Eastern Europe and the Eastern districts of the Austro-Hungarian Empire and mainly minorities. Dr. Kürti will have a contribution regarding a very interesting person, Ludwig Lesser, a German-born politician, was very active after the fall of the Austro-Hungarian Empire on the western borders of what will be Hungary or post-war Hungary. So, Dr. Kürti, the word is yours.
Thank you for the invitation to be part of this conference. And it's an amazing city. I wanted to be here always with the session. And today I will present a very interesting person who actually not really well known, but was very influential in the life of the Austrian politics and also in the Hungarian political life. My contribution is about the afterlife of the First World War, how can build an identity for a territory which never existed before, and how can we, for the people, identity in a territory which never existed before. He is Ludwig Lesser. He was born in Hungary, in Neufeld, the Leita today name, Leita we follow in Hungary. I would like to present some details about his very adventurous and very controversial life. He attended the high school in Ödemo, Sopron. Is a very important city in my presentation, and also in fate of Burgenland and Hungary. In the World War, he served in the Honvéd Infantry Regiment and became involved in Neufeld, in the Social Democratic Party. He became one of the leaders of the Social Democratic Party. In 19 April, during the time of the Council government, was elected to the County Council in Sopron. This is the communist period, the Kumbéla regime. The establishment of the German West Hungary became Gaurakt, and very influential position in the Council Republic. Responsible for the cultural school, this is a very important element in his life, connection with the culture and the school system, in Ödemo, of course. After the fall of Kumbéla government in 19 August, Lesser was appointed government commissioner for German West Hungary. In 20, was arrested by the Horthy regime, but managed to escape to Austria, and here began a new life for him. In 22 January, became a member of the administrative office of the forming Burgenland and the permanent three-man committee administrative office. He has never been, except a very short time before his death, the first man of Burgenland. He was always the deputy government of Burgenland, but was very influential in Burgenland life. Until 34, it was deputy government and chairman also the Social Democratic Party of Burgenland. In 31, became an honorary doctor in Heidelberg. I explain why later. In 34, he had to escape from after the putsch in Austria, after the Nazi takeover in Austria, escaped Bratislava, Brünn, and later Prague. Here Prague came the maybe the darkest and less investigated period of his life, because in 2004 came out that he in Prague became an agent of the Nazi regime. As an undercover agent under the codename Lederer and S-26, but he had an extensive contact with socialists all over Europe and also the representative Austrian resistance, the Czech resistance too. In 45, after the Second World War, he returned to Austria and he participated in the rebuilding of Germany. And for a short time became appointed provisional governor. And after the election, in 45, became newly deputy governor, and in 46 died. It was his very adventurous life. I am focusing only this period between 21 and 31, these 10 years in his life. And here is the map, today map of Austria, and Burgenland is the first, the one, this green part. And this is also Burgenland in other map, this today situation. The main question, main issue was in the first period, the question of capital, the provincial capital. Burgenland never existed. Became this province from three former Hungarian county. In Hungarian, sometimes named Deutsch-Westungar, you got Magyarország. But actually didn't have a provincial capital. Sopron, Ödenburg would have been very appropriate for a capital city because his fantastic theaters, cafes, a very urbanized city was, archives, library, etc. In 21 January, the first Burgenland law designated Sopron as provincial capital, but in reality, the capital or the seat of the government was in Savonyukút, in Sauerbrunn. This is a very small, very famous box city in today Burgenland. It's very important in my presentation in regarding Lézer personality. A significant part of the first generation, the Burgenland leaders, like Lézer, pretty much connected to Sok. For example, also the second governor of Burgenland, Waldheck, who was born in Sopron, for example. And also Lézer was very connected to this city, also emotionally. And that's why it was for him very big loss of this city. In Venice Protocol in 21 October, closed the border issue, seemingly, but this Venice Protocol called a referendum and plebiscite for the situation, for the status of Sopron and other nine different neighbor small villages. In November 21, formed the Ödenburger Heimatdienst. This is an institution Austrian oriented, actually its best was to promote the joining Austria. Also member, Leser was a member of this Ödenburger Heimatdienst, and very interesting, at this time already heavily attacked by the Hungarian press, the Horthy regime press, due to his role in Council Republic in communist period. The premiership in December, this back later, lost Sopron for Austria and also these nine small villages. This loss of Sopron determined Leser further political views, always mentioned the Hungarian revisionism, strong, and became this conduct in his political view and very strong commitment to the German state, for the German Empire, and became a hard promoter to Anschluss, for Anschluss. This is the red line is the today borderline. And yeah, here is Sopron Ödenburg. Okay. It's very interesting and little bit funny element in this period. In December, the member of the Ödenburger Heimatdienst, first of all the social democrat member of the Heimatdienst, wanted action against Hungary for reconquest Sopron, like Gabriel D'Annunzio infamous action for Fiume 2 years before. This was unreal and a little bit comic. Even though the other parties from Austria supported this thought. 21 December, the Council of Ambassadors adopted the result of the election, the Polish referendum of Sopron, and finished the border question decisively. The very important notion, this Lebensunfähigkeit, unviability, that means without Sopron, without cities, Burgenland couldn't be viable like province, independent province. And Leser had a very important role to prevent, in the prevention of Burgenland partition, because many times turned up to dividing Burgenland between the two other neighboring province, Lower Austria and Styria. In 23 March happened the first Austrian census in Burgenland. You can see the numbers, almost 300,000 inhabitants, only 50 because Hungarians. This is in this time significant decline, the ethnic minor Hungarian ethnic in Burgenland. In 23 August, there happened a hard debate about provincial capital, because it's still Savonyukút, the capital of Burgenland. And only in 25 became Eisenstadt, the today capital, Kismarton in Hungarian, but not capital, Zitz des Landesregierung, that's been a seat of the province. And what does it mean, Burgenland's identity? How can form a new identity for these people, dwellers of this territory? For a long time, mean a kind of special entity between Austria and Hungary. For the social democrats in Austria, like Leser, emphasized always the modernization of Burgia law. That means modernization, making the people German. Because in Burgia law live not only Hungarians, but also Croatians. Also Jewish minority lived in Burgia law. Make German these people. And of course, attempt to break with the traditional ethnic hierarchy. On the high top of the hierarchy stand, of course, the Hungarians before. For the social democrats, Burgenland means the Hungarian culture, according to Peter Hesslinger, an historian from Innsbruck, food means backwardness, economic and infrastructural neglect, feudal nature, political life, corruption, incompetence, brutality. The term ASEAN was used to define Hungarian essence, incompatible with both European norms of political culture and the needs of German population of Burgia law. Not by chance, Leser in 22 used the word Europeization. For him, means Europeization far away from the Hungarian past, modernized Burgia law. And the other, what does it mean, identity and territory building? To construct geographical and historical arguments, very important. Knowledge making, actually. Process through which Burgia law was discovered, because this territory must have been discovered for the Austrian point of view. And even Burgia law was, of course, part of a broader domestic project, because also Austria must have been invented. What is Austrian identity in this time? Also a new country. But I also aimed at an education of citizens about the local history and the touristic opportunities within a newly created state. Leser in Burgenland was also responsible for the touristic and cultural efforts. I would like only short present a few statements about from Leser's about Burgenland's identity and from his many articles. Only selected. Das Burgenland in Deutschland, 2028. Our Burgenland South. So, although we are good Austrians, we feel a better sense of belonging to the German Empire than other Austrian territories. Other article. Anti-Austrian policy of the Hungarians who didn't renounce Burgia law. Please to German public to support the Burgia law's endeavors. Other article. Leser described Burgia law as a colorful province. Burgia law remained actually between the two worlds also the most ethnically most colorful territory in Austria. Croatian, Hungarian, Jewish people, and Germans, which shaped and influenced not only by its Hungarian past, but also by the unique cultural practice of two indigenous ethnically German subgroups. Very important notion in his life. Always mentioned the indigenous German tribes, the Bavarians and Franks in this territory from the Middle Age. About Burgenland's character. Traced to German origins, of course, repeat always. The era back to Charles the Great, because it belonged in Middle East, this part, the early Middle Ages in Frank, Charles the Great Empire, Frankish and Bavarian settlers. And his hope, Germany will extend not only between Maas and Memel, but also between Rabon, Rabin, Hungary, and the Danube, all three to now occupy Saarland. Very important, this last sentence, the migration. Unfortunately, the economic situation in Burgenland, Austria, and Austria in the 20s and 30s was very, very bad. Always worsening the situation, and was very strong the migration from Burgenland to other parts of Austria. This mentioned also later. He visited a lot of time Germany to promote Burgenland and to collect support, also financial support. One of the most important in 1929 lecture tour in German cities drew attention to the efforts of people of Burgenland. The significance of his personality is shown by the fact that prominent figures in the German political life also appeared in his reception. He, of course, spoke about the 600 years of Hungarian oppression and spoke about the very important development in this during this 10 years. It's the last his work about Burgenland. Every 10 years in Burgenland, published by the government, and review in which summarized the achievement of the past 10 years, and this is the article of Leser, but from his point of view, the achievement, the results in the last 10 years, the OZP, the German connection, difficulty to create a provincial archive, because the archive of the county seat are remaining in Hungary, this is true, mentioned the new archive and the libraries, 26 archaeological excavation started in Burgenland to invent Burgenland. I mentioned the person who visited and investigated and researched the territory, and the books which published about and after this expedition, can I say? 27 Dagobert Frey traveled to Burgenland to explore from the historical point of view. This summarized later. And the last, my person is the evaluation of Leser, and I quoted, will quote a very important person, Fred Zinnemann, the former Chancellor of Austria, also first man of the Social Democratic Party of Austria. Also, he was born in Burgenland, heavily connected to his region. But he thought about laser activity. The most important, according Fred Zinnemann, awakening of the Burgenland self-awareness, a laser struggle for the independence of Burgenland province, is true, building the Burgenland administration, honorary doctorate, University of Heidelberg, because his connection with the, Germany, and the first socialist, is true, who attacked by the Nazis. It's also unfortunately true. And thank you for the attention.